Welcome to Roaring News, a Tiger Television production, celebrating our homeschool community one story at a time. Reporting from our news desk here in beautiful Yardley, Pennsylvania, let us enlighten your minds in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now it is time for our Town Hall and Awards Assembly celebration. To our fifth grade students, this may be your last town hall virtually, but you will always be with us in our hearts. Please rise and join us for a virtual choral performance of the Ode to Edgewood. At this time, we'd like to recognize those students who have qualified under the revised credentials for the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence in 2020. These are students who have performed in either an advanced in math or reading with a proficient in any other area on the fourth grade PSSA. There are students in fourth grade who have a mode of C's and no B's on the grade 4 report card in the content of math, reading, English language arts, science, and social studies. And finally, in fifth grade, they've had a mode of C's or commendable progress with no basics through the first two marking periods of the fifth grade year in the content areas of math, reading, English language arts, science, and social studies. Congratulations to our winners. They will be receiving a Presidential Excellence of Award pin and certificate. At this time, we'd like to celebrate our Roars ambassadors who played a strategic role in showing and sharing the Roars characteristics of expected behavior throughout the course of the school year through many service projects. Beginning with our Roars virtual lesson skit performers who came in over the summer to teach us about the true behaviors of Roars, one place and one characteristic at a time, we thank you for your efforts. Also recognizing students who participated in the Say Hello project as ambassadors, leading us with more ways of including and welcoming others. Finally, those students who are involved in writing words of wisdom on our message board with inspirational quotes for us to ponder. We thank you for your words of wisdom. And for those students who served with us on a day off, a day on in servitude, for Martin Luther King Day Service Project and the United We Serve Ambassadorship, thank you for your service. Finally, students who were involved as well with us in compilating quotes and videos for our celebration of Black History Month, we thank you for your time, inspiration, and motivational quotes. Also, for our fire drill runners who helped us safely and securely, most efficiently, return into the building post the fire drill while all students were accounted for. Thank you for your safety. And to our town hall ushers who helped us dance our way into each town hall meeting with assembly expectations on whole body listening, we will never forget your fancy moves. For our student safeties, ambassadors of safety, keeping us on track as we exited the building and came in the mornings, we thank you, fall safeties. And we thank you, winter safeties.
Our safeties out there, we just want to say thank you for all of your efforts. The kindergarten and first graders made it to the right buses because of you. Walkers were reminded to actually walk, and you helped them get safely across the crosswalk. You also helped your peers to behave appropriately in the halls and on the buses. I'm sorry that the winter safeties were shortchanged on performing their duties, but we really appreciate all that you were able to achieve and say thank you very much.
Also, a vote of thanks goes to our Top Tiger production crew, whose ingenuity, creativity, and fast thinking helped us bring ourselves into the 21st century in a creative way at Edgewood with Top Tiger Productions. Congratulations on being the first ever production crew at Edgewood. And now it is time to recognize students who have been nominated by either their classroom teachers or at-home parent and guardians for showing their oars in our virtual learning environment. Congratulations. A special message from our Field Day PTO committee.
Oh,
Again, thank you, PTO and Mrs. McGoldrick, for that wonderful compilation celebrating a virtual field day experience. We really appreciate it. Now it is time for us to honor those who are recipients, being recognized students K through 5 who have zero absences for honorary attendance for the school year through the date of March 13th, pre-COVID. Here are our honorary attendance winners who will receive an award. In kindergarten, first, second, and third grade. Students in fourth and fifth grade. Also, we want to give a special kudos to all the students who bravely dared to creatively come up with the design for the yearbook cover. The winning award will go to, you'll have to wait to find out once you get your yearbooks. Here are the theme of Power Out entries. Congratulations again to all of your artwork. At this time, we'd like to give a special shout out to our Brain Train students on behalf of Mrs. Dobb Vigilante and Mr. Gallo. Any student with an asterisk participated in all three marking periods.
Hi, it's Mrs. Dobb here. Mrs. B and I would like to thank all our brain train helpers for all of your great work. We look forward to seeing our fourth graders again next year. To our fifth graders, the best of luck to you in your new school. Thank you for all of your help. We couldn't have done it without you. The best, and have a great summer.
Also, special thanks to our student council students representing those in fourth and fifth grade who helped for decision-making and planning for school-wide events throughout the school year. In fifth grade, in fourth grade, and also the leadership team, co-presidents, vice president, secretary, and treasurer.
Hi, boys and girls. It's amazing that we're already at the end of the school year. It seems like just yesterday that we had our student council elections, the first of which were ever televised for the fourth and fifth grade classes. So this year was a special year for student council. Our group of students was particularly amazing. You were all incredibly hard workers, stepped up to the plate anytime we asked you to do anything special. You made wonderful contributions honoring our veterans by cutting out stars and on the recycled flags, as well as the hats, gloves, and scarves drive that we had in January for the children living on the Native American reservations. So even though our school year with regards to student council was cut short, we still had a pretty significant contribution of community service projects that we were able to put into place. And that was the direct result of the fact that we have such an amazing group of kids. So I look forward to seeing our fourth graders again next year. And to our fifth graders, I hope you pursue service opportunities at the middle school next year. From Mrs. Marco and myself, have a wonderful summer and thank you for all that you did.
Now it is time to recognize all students participating in one of the four teams for Reading Olympics. The Roaring Readers with lowercase O-R-E-R, the D's Books Group. The Roaring Readers Caps and Winslow Warriors.
Hi, Reading Olympics friends. I just wanted to say congratulations on all the books that you guys read this year and all the quizzes that you took and how hard you worked to read. And I'm sorry we didn't get to have our event, but I know how hard you worked and you get a certificate for all of that. I hope you have an awesome summer. I miss you and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Special thanks as well to our Spark assistants.
Hi, this is Mrs. Holmes from Spark. I want to thank so much the Spark helpers that I had this year. We did so much with robots, working with the kindergarten program, and we had a great time. You gave up your recesses. You were amazing. You gave out your lunches, too. Lila Curtis, Sophia Smith, Peyton Worth, Gabrielle Sweeney, and there were some others who I just grabbed whenever I was desperate. So thank you so much. I think Dash wants to say something as well. See if I can get it to talk.
Dash wants to say thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.
Also, congratulations to our art club.
Congratulations, art club. I'm so sorry that this year ended the way it did. But you guys are talented, you're creative. I hope that you'll remember the project that we did with the Endabelly dolls and the houses in which they lived. Keep creating, keep drawing, and just do your best when you go to the middle school. Show them the skills that you have developed through the years. Good luck, best wishes, and take care. Bye-bye.
Hi, Edgewood, it's Mrs. Kimmock. At this time, I want to be able to congratulate some of our fifth grade students who were involved in some very special music activities. We had two students who were involved in the Oaks National Children's Choir, and we also had 13 students who were involved in the Pensbury Honors Choir. Both of these choirs meant that they needed to come to extra rehearsals either before school or during recess. They donated their time and hard work to be able to learn some really challenging music. So I honor them, and I hope that they will continue in some way in middle school to continue into the music. Congratulations.
Congratulations to our two Oak National Choir Award winners in 2020. To our District Honors Choir. And for instrumental music, congratulations to all the fourth and fifth grade students who participated in the spring concert rehearsals. And the students specifically by instrument. Please note students with an asterisk are in their second year, and any student with a hashtag signifies honors orchestra status. Also, congratulations to all Pensbury Elementary Honors Orchestra.
Hi, this is Mrs. Chippendale. I'm the orchestra teacher at Edgewood, and I am here to congratulate our students who were in orchestra this year. They did a great job at rehearsals and lessons. I just wish we could have had a spring concert so they could have showed off their skills to you. I thank them for their hard work and their learning, and also congratulations to our eight students who were chosen for the Honors Orchestra this year. I hope to see everyone back at Edgewood next year or at Charles Bain.
For Mr. Bygott, congratulations to our instrumental music band team members in grades 4 and 5. Here are those students in grade 4 by instrument. And those students in grade 5 by instrument. Also, congratulations to our All Pensbury Elementary Honors Band.
Congratulations, Edgewood Band members, on the completion of the school year. Thank you for all of your hard work, including all of the video lessons you submitted during the closure. I know it must have been disappointing not to be able to have our spring concert performance, but know that you will have many more performances in the future. I look forward to teaching the fourth graders next year and wish the best of luck to the fifth graders as they move up to Charles Bain. I can't wait to share the stage with you again when you reach Pensbury High School, where I'm one of the directors. Keep practicing and stay Edgewood strong.
Congratulations as well to our GOB participants, students in fourth and fifth grade. Those team members are as follows. And also to Siona Emin and Rowan O'Neill, who qualified at the state level.
Congratulations to our fourth and fifth grade students who participated in the National Geography Bee this year. The following slides name the students who advanced to rounds 2 and 3 and our final round. Congratulations, everyone.
Now we'd like to celebrate any student who was involved in Fuel Up to Play 60 this year. And the Fuel Up team members.
Hi, Megan.
Hi, I'm Ivana.
Hi, I'm Madison.
Hi, I'm Katie.
Hi, I'm Sydney.
Hi, we are the Edgewood Field to Play 60 Ambassadors.
Thank you to everyone who came to the recesses this year.
Thanks for participating in the Taste Test and Grab and Go.
We hope you had fun with the Bob Kelly visit.
We want you to continue to stay active this summer.
Also, at this time, we'd like to recognize all of our Top Tiger recognized winners for the months of October, December, and February. Congratulations on showing your roars. Thank you for those final words of wisdom for a Words of Wisdom Wizard. And now it is time that you have been waiting for to award our final round of superhero capes and cuffs to students showing their roars.
Hey, Edgewood family, DJ T-Dog here, just wishing you a great last week of school. Keep moving, keep dancing. We're so excited. Congratulations to all of the CAPE winners, to our fifth graders who are graduating, and we want you to have a great summer. Peace out.
This student is everything a Roars student should be. What stands out the most is his overwhelming kindness. His open heart is so big that it shines through everything he does. The student has been loving and encouraging to his classmates through the entire school year, but even more so during virtual learning. He responsibly completes his assignments and shows his desire to achieve by going above and beyond what is expected of him. In a time when we may be worried, this student's smile can make it all better. Please join me in congratulating John Baker. You have been awarded a cape.
When I say John, you say hero. John!
Hero!
John!
Hero!
John!
Hero!
John, we wanted to celebrate you because in addition to your roars behavior at school and always just being very kind to everyone, during this time period of distance learning, you were so very supportive and we just all really appreciated that very much. Whether it was a response to a morning greeting or helping other kids that may have had a question that I didn't get to yet, you were just such a wonderful friend throughout all of this, consistently. And I just wanted to say we appreciate that. We wish we could all be with you today to celebrate this amazing accomplishment. and we can't wait to see you wearing your cape in the fall. Okay, bye. Congratulations.
When I think about a student who demonstrates ROARS behavior, this girl has it all. In addition to the entire school year, she has really stood out during this virtual learning time. Her kindness and willingness to help her teacher from a student's perspective have been so very much appreciated. She is encouraging and helpful to her classmates, respectful and engaged during our Google Meets, and goes above and beyond in her daily assignments. I am so proud that she has been able to maintain such a positive attitude even when things have been challenging. This student can be counted on, and that is such a wonderful way to be seen. Please join me in congratulating Dakota Hipschman. You have earned a cape.
When I say Dakota, you say hero. Dakota!
Hero!
Dakota!
Hero!
Dakota!
Hero!
Dakota, we wanted to celebrate you because in addition to your amazing ROARS behavior in school and acting as such a positive role model, during this new time period where everything was very new to all of us, you were such a huge help to me and allowing me to test things out on you. You would tell me what was working and what wasn't working. Always with such a willingness to help and such a positive attitude, and it was just so very much appreciated. So you really made me feel like you were open-hearted. So I appreciate that very much, and we wish we could all be there with you to help you celebrate. We can't wait to see you wearing your cape in the fall.
This student is a pleasure to have in the classroom. Always has a smile on her face. The student works hard in all subject areas and is often commendable in her work. She takes pride in completing her answers with thoroughness and does anything without question. The student has volunteered for classroom jobs even though she was involved in other activities outside of her classroom day. This student has taken a role inside the building of Brain Train and lifted it up to the next level. She is eager to intercept young kindergarten students who may need a little extra push and being kind to them and hugging them if they need it just in time. This student has always seemed to be getting everyone on the right track. Please join me in congratulating Peyton Worth. You are receiving a cape.
I say Peyton, you say hero.
Hey Peyton, I just want to congratulate you on winning a cape. I heard all the great things that you've been doing in Brain Train, and I agree that you also do great things in the classroom, hardworking, and always have a smile on your face. So congrats.
This student is amazing inside and out. He puts all into everything he does and is super focused. He has consistently shown his ROARS for the last 2 years, even in kindergarten and first grades. Now, he is even more kind-hearted and always strives to rise higher and work harder. He is smart but never brags. He is always ready to listen, not only to his teachers, but his classmates. He is a unique out-of-the-box thinker, always looking for a different angle to creatively solve problems. He wants to see others succeed and gets very excited when they do. We hope his love for learning only continues to strengthen as he moves through Edgewood and life. Stay curious and keep being you. Please join me in congratulating Luke was chosen. You have earned a cape.
When I say Luke, you say hero. Luke!
Hero!
Luke!
Hero!
Luke!
Hero!
Hi, Luke. Congratulations on a well-deserved cape. You are an incredible little human being, and we know that you are going to continue to be one as you move through Edgewood. Always remember to be you and wear your cape proudly.
Hey Luke, congratulations, buddy. I am so happy for you and couldn't be more proud. You earned this cape. You were an amazing student when you were in my class. And you are the kindest soul with the biggest heart. And what a hard worker you are. Way to go, Luke. So proud of you, pal.
This student embodies all the Roar's characteristics consistently and has done so since the beginning of the school year. She always completes her work to the best of her abilities and often exceeds the teacher's expectations. As a respectful classmate, she's a role model for all students. Her open-heartedness extends beyond just being kind and friendly. She truly cares for all students and makes an effort to be sure children who may not be treated kindly are looked out for with regards to safety and well-being. She can be counted on to make decisions that facilitate learning while having fun. Teacher writes, I'm so glad to have the privilege of being her fifth grade teacher. Please join me in congratulating. Lauren Leonard, congratulations.
When I say Lauren, you say hero. Lauren.
Hero.
Lauren.
Hero.
Lauren.
Hero.
Congratulations, Lauren. I'm so incredibly proud of you, and I'm so thrilled that you were able to be a recipient for this next level of recognition for Roar's qualities and characteristics. There's no one more deserving than you.
This student is an exemplary member of the Edgewood community. The teacher writes, I have thought of her all year, but what made her jump to mind is who she is during these unprecedented times. The student does her schoolwork every single day. I know she watches my instructional videos because she emails me the word of the day. She comes to our Google Meets consistently and is always willing to chat or play along with whatever game we come up with. She has such a good attitude and sense of humor. She seems to be taking things in stride, which is not easy for a fifth grader during a pandemic. She has truly risen to this enormous challenge. I don't think she realizes how nice it is to have her as a student. This student has been a valuable member of our class. She works well with every student she is grouped with and exhibits every Roar's trait. Please join me in congratulating Amanda Fichtel. You have been awarded a cape.
When I say Amanda, you say hero. Amanda.
Hero.
Amanda.
Hero.
Amanda.
Hero.
Amanda, congratulations. You truly deserve this cape. From the start, you were a role model to the class and continue to be. Your positive attitude and good work ethic have not gone unnoticed. Miss Priya and I are so proud of you.
You're such a great girl with such a good sense of humor, and you're flexible, and you've had such a good attitude even through these past 3 months. I know you will be successful in all your future endeavors. Congratulations.
This student models Roar's characteristics while in school and at home. He makes a conscious effort to do the right thing. Whether it is in the classroom or on the playground, he is sure to keep himself and others at Edgewood safe. Although he is very quiet and soft-spoken, he makes his presence known in a subtle, thoughtful ways. Most importantly, he is a good friend to everyone and gets along with all classmates and only has kind words to say about them. He builds his classmates up, making people feel good about themselves. He is positive and insightful. He goes beyond simply being cooperative. He is inclusive of everyone. Since we have been in distance learning from home, this student continues to show that he is responsible, always turning in his assignments. He is appreciative of others by sharing with his classmates and thinking of them and me during Google Meet sessions. He understands the true meaning of Roars. Please join me in congratulating Joey McManus. Congratulations on your cape.
When I say Joey, you say hero. Joey!
Hero!
Joey!
Hero!
Joey!
Hero!
Hi, Edgewood, and hi, Joey. Joey, congratulations. I'm so happy for you. Thank you for being an awesome RUHR student. Thanks for always doing the right thing, completing your work, giving your best effort during distance learning. Most importantly, thank you for being everyone's friend and being kind and positive. So congratulations and enjoy your CAPE.
This student has transitioned into this new learning experience with such a positive attitude. She is a true Edgewood Tiger and is consistently demonstrating RUHR's behavior. This student is responsibly completing her assignments daily and focuses on her achievement by completing these assignments with diligence and care. Respectful in a virtual learning environment is exactly who she is. During Google Class meetings, she is attentive and responsive to her teacher. It is easy to see her open heart through the encouraging online messages she writes to her classmates. When this student had unexpected distant front lawn visit from a class friend, she cried tears of joy. At a time when we are all doing our very best to stay safe, this student is doing it with a smile. Please join me in congratulating Mia Ortiz. Congratulations on your CAPE.
You say hero. Mia!
Hero!
Mia!
Hero!
Mia!
Hero!
Congratulations, Mia! First, I want to say I am so proud of every single one of the students in my class. Mia, the reason we decided to celebrate you today is because in addition to you showing RUHR's behavior throughout the entire school year, you have maintained such a positive attitude during this new experience. And I know that that was not always the easiest thing to do, and I'm just so very proud of you. We all wish we could be there with you right now to celebrate this amazing accomplishment, and we can't wait to see you wearing your CAPE in the fall. Okay, bye, congratulations.
There are some students who can light up a room with joy in their life. This is that student. This student is very focused and responsible. She immediately gets to work on any task at hand and completes it to the best of her ability. Joyfully volunteering for Braintrain was immediately someone that was loved by students. In class, she is open-hearted and friendly to everyone. She makes others feel welcome to join in and treats everyone with respect. Most notably, this student's infectious joy for life has continued during distance learning. Every assignment turned in has been completed above and beyond expectation. Not only is this an exceptional student, but she is also an exceptional member of our family. I have no doubt that this student will wear a CAPE with pride and continue to show RUHR's and be a role model for Edgewood School. Please join me in congratulating Kira Socha. Congratulations on earning your CAPE.
When I say Kira, you say hero. Kira.
Hero.
Kira.
Hero.
Kira.
Hero.
Congratulations, Kira, on earning your CAPE today. It has been an honor to be your fourth grade teacher, and you so deserve this recognition. I cannot wait to see you next year in fifth grade with that CAPE on. Congratulations.
This student is the first student to lend a helping hand. The first to cheer up a friend, the first to put another classmate's needs first before her own, and the first to show that she is ready to learn. This student has already earned a CAPE in the past for demonstrating amazing RUHR's behaviors. But she continues to lead by example throughout her days at Edgewood. She's a true model for all. Please join me in congratulating Caitlin Sheehan. Congratulations on powering up and earning your cuffs.
When I say Caitlin, you say hero. Caitlin.
Hero.
Caitlin.
Hero.
Caitlin.
Hero.
Hi, Caitlin.
Caitlin, congratulations on earning your cuffs. I am so proud of you. You deserve it. Thank you for everything you've done this year in my classroom. Your ability just to feel deeply for others and just showing acts of kindness that we greatly need in the world today. And I feel blessed having you in my class. Continue to spread your message to others. Be that example of seeing the good and enjoy your summer. Thank you so much.
Congratulations to our newly awarded cape and cuff winners. The Edgewood Tiger and I will be around this afternoon to deliver your capes and cuffs using the rules of social distancing, of course. Thank you all for joining us today for our first ever virtual town hall meeting. We hope you make it a great day.
Keep on dancing, Edgewood.
That is all the buzz from our school news desk on this day. We hope you are feeling informed. In our tradition of words of wisdom, make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.